guys, it's me, Jaden. It is actually October 14th, 2019, and I decided that I would film, well, I already wanted to film some of these. I wanted to film some Create With Me Inktobers. I don't know what to say that, but I decided to do today and the 18th. They will be uploaded way after those days, most likely. As far as I know, they will be. But I decided to do these days because I really like the prompts and I thought that it'd be fun to make into a video. So without further ado, let's get into day 14's Inktober process. So I look like a little bit of a crap today.
Whoa, dude.
So I think that I should first show you a few of the things that I use. So for inks, this is a pen that I use. It's a regular pen. It doesn't work anymore. But I also use a black Sharpie, and for whatever thing that I want to do that day, I pick a color of a Copic to use. Today, I'm going to do a green ink. I'm allowing myself to use a green ink, so I'm just going to pick out a few greens, and I'll swatch them in a little bit. I already have an idea for my drawing today. I was inspired by the house off of Madeline, because Madeline's one of my favorite names. I'm going to name my kid that, maybe. That is so random. Off topic. Their little orphanage / school thing, I don't exactly know what it's called, has a bunch of vines going up it, and I thought it'd be really cute to do a cute little house or building, something like that, with little vines going up it. So I use a normal pencil. I use a mechanical one for some reason. I think I use some weird supplies, but you can be the judge of that. And then I use this eraser. And my sketchbook. I don't ever sketch anything out beforehand. I just go into it and erase a few times if I think I need to. Let's swatch some of these greens and see which one we think would look cute as a little vine. I actually do this step after I draw, but for video's sake, I'm just gonna get into it. I am using a new tripod that I've never used in a video, but actually I did in a vlog. But let's swatch this. This one is the G335. Not a fat fan, but we can see how the others look. This one is the G515. One ain't bad. This one is the G554. No, no. I'm just gonna put this one away. It's a G406. So, I already know that I'm going to use this one, which is this color. This is my first year doing Inktober. I have missed a few days. A few days I've caught up on, a few days I'm just not going to bother. So, I am thinking, I just have a line. I'm thinking about doing something similar to my September bullet journal spread. I'll show you that. This, like a little village scene thingy. But more simplistic. I'm going to speed this up a bit, guys. I am done, and I'm going to start inking with this. Hopefully it actually has more than I think of ink in it. Okay, nope. I'm planning on going somewhere to get actual microns because I use stuff like this a lot, and I use ink pens, like actual ink pens for it, instead of stuff that you need to use for art. To ink my stuff with. I kind of wanted this to look a little bit like some place a gnome or something would live. I don't know why, but I got inspired to do something like that. I was like, this kind of looks like something a gnome would live in. I think I should go ahead and put the vines on. I think overgrown is, well, I thought about ivies. My name was gonna be Ivy, but it's Jaden instead, which I'm kind of disappointed about, not gonna lie, but it's like, okay. I still love myself. Even though I look like a burnt chicken nugget, I still love myself. Okay, I have to know who all quoted that vine with me. Show of hands in the comments. Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening. Go stupid. America. It's actually a lot different than I had planned, but I like it so much. But thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. It was quick, but you know, I just thought that I'd had to do a freaking Inktober video. But I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Like, subscribe, and comment, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye. 'Cause I'm